Sorry, I know you don't want to bring it up because you're tight, but like,
I'm a little tight.
I'm gonna let you know that my boys, Dakil Sage and Dill,
they are actually broken. Your boys from New York.
They both from New York. Got so top eight at Combo Breaker. Taking as Zoro didn't actually make top eight, so you know he's probably a little bit hurt about that. So he's here at Naito Osaka, trying to prove people wrong that hey, I'm still good. I can still put in some work. And he's fighting against I'm Hip's Olimar.
I think I had the opportunity to commentate one of I'm Hip's sets at Civil War in doubles. Let's see how well his doubles gameplay translates over into singles. As you see, fresh out of the gate here, Zenodo knows how to maneuver around these Pikmin. Okay, nice. His back air is the white one. Oh, but he has the purple one on deck. You got to watch out.
Yeah, as Olimar has the ability to just switch between Pikmin, it's going to be in a set order. It always goes red, blue, yellow, white, purple, I believe, or purple, white, one of the two.
Yeah.
But regardless, you can only have three on stage at once. You're going to see a lot of double purples coming into play because they live just a little longer.
And even as strong as a purple one is, the one you have to watch out for is the blue one. Once that blue one comes into gameplay and you have high percent, you have got to stay on your toes.
Because you don't want to get grabbed.
Oh,
the blue Pikmin has such a good grab with high knockback, high damage.
Again, Zenodo not really getting a chance to get his banana peel gameplay started. Every time he pulls one out, I'm Hip is there with the coverage.
For a second, I thought that banana peel was the yellow Pikmin. I was like, wait, how does he have four Pikmin?
Oh, God.
I was caught completely off guard by that.
Brawl Day is coming soon. No, I'm joking. I'm joking, man. Okay, the forwarder, give himself a little breathing space.
And now he has the two Pikmin, which are required for a kill, purple and blue. If it's purple, it's going to be a smash attack. If it's blue, it's going to be a grab. But Zenodo, showing no fear, gets right in there, throwing a banana peel into a... Wow!
Yeah, and despite, you know, the Pikmin being on him, still running right into the face of danger with the double down tilt. Didn't quite get the first conversion he was looking for, and wow, I'm Hip answers back and silences the audience with a back air. A
reverse aerial rush back air, no less. He charged into him and just immediately threw it out there.
He said, I know you're not going to be ready for it. Oh, okay.
Tries to get the tech beat into an up smash, but it was just a little bit too soon on it. I guess he was expecting him not to tech whatsoever.
We cannot sleep on Olimar, man. A lot of people talk about his projectile gameplay. He's spammy, you know, he's zone heavy, whatever it is. But when he gets in those low percent combos, he tacks on a heaping amount of percent, and that's exactly what we're seeing here.
Now he's landing the white Pikmin, and the white Pikmin being really good for whenever he throws it on an opponent, does the most damage per second.
Yeah.
When it's just like wailing on him. You want to get that off of you ASAP.
Oh.
And we have the double purples coming to Legend. He actually didn't want double purple. He threw one of them away in order to try to get a blue for a mix-up game.
Yeah, you only really need one. So, I mean, the purple ones force you to get in a little closer on Diddy Kong. And with Diddy Kong in that strong neutral, it's a little difficult for Olimar. Sometimes when it catches him with the upper as he recovers high. Now Zenodo has the potassium back in hand. He hasn't really been able to convert off of it, and I think that's due to the overall utilization of I'm Hip's Pikmin game.
Yeah, he's using him to their full maximum because that actually killed. What? I thought Zenodo was living that. I thought he was DIing it correctly, but he just died. I'm Hip taking away game number one.
I'm Hip is very hip to the Diddy Kong matchup, man. Sticking it to Zenodo game number one and setting the overall tone for this set.
Well, there's one thing I wanted to bring up that I'm Hip was doing wonderful against Diddy Kong is we're definitely probably going to see a counterpick coming from Zeno. What Olimar has against Diddy Kong is he can throw a Pikmin, and the Pikmin can drag the banana peel away from Zenodo.
Make it out of arm's reach.
Yeah, keep it out of arm's reach, so it kind of almost diffuses the item. But Zenodo is still going to stick with his Diddy Kong. He's keeping it back. He spawned the banana peel yet again. That's probably why I was confusing the banana peel for Pikmin, because it was like moving along with them, you know?
You got it.
Because the Olimars are good at picking up items. You ever played Pikmin 1, 2, or 3? That's what they do.
Never played them on purpose, man, but they look like pretty cool games. I can't lie to you. But nonetheless, though, move right into game number two here. These guys are neck and neck, going tit for tat, trading blows. Zenodo gets the banana peel in hand, but couldn't quite get there in time because that blue Pikmin is on top of his head.
But Zenodo, you know, landing that down tilt and a down smash, establishing stage control by pushing I'm Hip off stage.
There it is. Okay, nice short hop forward there, man. Those things look virtually lagless.
I'm seeing a more aggressive Zenodo this time around, you know, just getting into I'm Hip's face, just pushing buttons, not allowing him to play any of his Pikmin game. That red Pikmin is going ham on Diddy Kong.
So stay off my mans.
Oh, that was almost a prime opportunity for Zenodo to possibly go off stage and land a back air or a down air if he was a little bit quicker on the upkeep.
Yeah, I think that's like the overall difference between this match and the last match. You know, they stayed on stage majority of the last game. This one, Zenodo looks like he wants to force him into a corner, if not off stage, to apply some pressure. Oh, and then ends up smashing his boys.
Zenodo doesn't actually care if there's a Pikmin on him.
No.
He just wants to get into, he's focusing completely on I'm Hip. He's like, I'll just take the damage as long as I don't forget the neutral.
There it is.
Because you can get distracted by the Pikmin that's on you.
Yeah, they're very taxing to deal with mentally. So are those devastating back airs. Zenodo closes out that first stock. You know, it started to kind of run away from Zenodo. He started out very strong. I'm Hip, you know, brought it back. clawed his way out of that deficit, but that backer just kind of sealed his fate.
And Imhyms out of jumps. This is Zeno's prime opportunity to get an edge guard up. But then he misses the roll onto the stage, and Imhip gets back on.
There it is. I like what Imhip was doing, though. Throwing those Pikmin to give himself some breathing space into Clank, into those forward airs, and just the aerial pressure that Diddy Kong was bringing.
And I know Imhip's looking for a kill opportunity. He has a purple Pikmin that he can use for, like, a smash attack opportunity.
Oh.
Purple's next on the list. I see an up smash coming unless he wants to phase him out.
There it is. 164 is quite the deficit to be in. Percentage-wise, the forward smash gets the yellow Pikmin, closes it out, and just like that, we have ourselves an even game here. Tries to get the banana pill from him. The pivot grabs are something I think a lot of people sleep on, too, with Olimar. Again, people don't think that he can get up close and personal and box and really stick it to you, but Olimar has some tricks up his sleeve. I'm a firm believer that he's like top five characters in the game with some of the strongest ground game.
Especially if you don't know the matchup.
Yeah, oh, definitely.
I love that he actually threw a Pikmin, and the Pikmin started bringing the banana peel back, but then Olimar slipped on the peel.
He's just running up and throwing Pikmin at this man. This is actually out of control.
Take this guy, take this guy, and this guy. Throwing all of his little soldiers at him.
All right. Okay, not that time. Again, not opting to throw the purple one this time. He wants to keep it intact on some percent.
Okay, getting the roll reads. A second time he gets a roll read with a down smash. Imhip trying to steal a little bit of momentum from Zenodo on the verge of knocking him out of the tournament, but Zenodo says no, hits him with a downtown into an up smash, and we have ourselves a game three scenario.
One of those unfortunate situations where your boys actually help you get killed. Like, your boys got you caught up. That up smash was, hitting the majority of the Pikmin, but I think, with that being said, Imhip kind of got caught into that. Now, in game number one, he was able to get out of that because the Pikmin were there. But that time, they ended up sealing his fate. Wow. Very interesting matchup here. Like we said, we don't get a chance to see a lot of high-level Pikmin. Obviously, Imhip is here. I believe he's from Vegas? Don't quote me. I'm not exactly sure.
Other Olimars I could possibly think of are like DeBuzz, obviously. He has a very strong Olimar. And then Myron that started to make like an explosive entrance at MomoCon.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'll never forget that set against Scat, dude. Olimar versus Mega Man was one of the most hyped sets you could have ever watched. And I never even thought that could be hype until I saw Myron versus Scat at MomoCon.
I think the match that put me on, well, I guess it wasn't even a match, just the tournament that put me onto Olimar at high level was obviously Frostbite. The fact that they had all those Japanese players here. But regardless, Shuta's not here. We have Imhip, but right now we have ourselves an even game. The down tilts, looking to punish his what could be lackluster landing. As he does have a hitbox on that up special. He's kind of a sitting duck out there.
And you speak about being turned on to Olimar. We see Zenodo just completely shutting off Olimar, saying this is not Olimar's rise to fame. I'm just going to make this a clean 2-1 victory and move on to my bracket.
Yeah.
Never have to deal with Olimar again.
Okay. Nice maneuvering out of the way of that banana peel in hand.
I love the counter pick coming from Imhip, going to Battlefield in order to just try to give him some more platforms to help him land against Diddy Kong.
Yeah, and I think the biggest difference between this match and the last one is that Zenodo's not boxing as much, trying to get him off stage.
That was so freaking scary, but they got the down tilt into up smash regardless. He went off stage, tried to catch him with a rocket barrel boost to hit Olimar while he was just constantly trying to use fly Pikmin.
This man really tried to barrel into him off stage. Like, that's how bad.
It works!
That's how bad, Olimar's recovery can be looked at. Okay. Does he get the down tilt? Does find access to a grab, though. Imhip off stage.
Yeah, and as you notice, he does throw a lot of his Pikmin before going into the winged Pikmin mode. Because if he has all three Pikmin on him, he gets so little distance, he has to throw them away in order to try to get as much distance as possible.
Which sucks because it just sets up, his neutral again, He has his Pikmin in order for a reason. And when he gets thrown off stage, he's just in a bad spot, not only because of his lackluster recovery, but because he has to throw all his Pikmin away.
But any good Olimar is able to just reset back to neutral and try to get all three Pikmin and just play with what he's got.
Absolutely.
That's what we're seeing from Imhip, but now he's trying to get overlapped in percent as Zenodo starts to adapt to his playstyle. We see him trying to call out that roll with a down smash.
Nice read there, just a little misposition, a little mistimed. Nonetheless, he's off stage again. Snaps ledge this time. Down tilt into border is enough to get that man banned.
There'll be no upset here today for Zenodo.
No, sir.
After losing that game one so closely, he's like, okay, I got my game plan. I'm going to come in. I'm going to shut down this Olimar by being hyper-aggressive, which Zenodo was not displaying in game number one. Zenodo was trying to play safe, trying to play the keep-away game from the Olimar. And then after that didn't end up working, I was like, I'm just going to go in, push buttons. There's nothing that Olimar can really do when I'm in his face like that.